Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have put together some questions related to the topic SN2 mechanism in primary halogenoalkanes. For links to other topics and question timestamps, please visit video description. Question 20. Bromoethane reacts with cyanide ions, producing propane nitrile. Which statement about the SN2 mechanism of this reaction is correct? A. The lone pair of electrons on carbon of CN negative attacks the carbon atom of the CBr bond. Let's find it out. Bromoethane, we have two carbon atoms. Bromine is electronegative, so carbon will become electropositive. Now CN will react by attacking this partial positive carbon atom, and what will happen that it will form CN bond, and this bromine bond will be broken. So the product will be like this. We have CH3, CH2, and CN. This is a product that is formed along with Br negative, that is substituted. So this is nucleophilic substitution reaction in which cyanide acts as a nucleophile and Br is substituted with CN negative. In the product, we have three carbon atoms and one nitrogen atom. So therefore, it is called propane, and due to nitrogen, it is called nitrile. So part A seems to be correct. Part B, the lone pair of electrons on carbon of CN negative attacks the carbocation formed when the CBr bond breaks. Now, bromoethane is primary halogenoalkane because this carbon is attached with only one carbon atom, while the carbocation is formed in tertiary halogenoalkanes. So this is incorrect. Part C, the lone pair of electrons on nitrogen of CN negative attacks the carbon atom of the CBr bond. This is incorrect because the attack is by carbon atom, not by nitrogen atom. If the attack was by nitrogen atom, then the bond would be formed directly with nitrogen. Now in this case, the carbon atoms makes a bond with carbon atom, so it means that lone pair of electrons is present on carbon atom rather than on nitrogen atom. Part D, the lone pair of electrons on nitrogen of CN negative, again this is incorrect, attacks the carbocation formed when CBr bonds breaks. And carbocation is also not formed in this case because this is primary halogenoalkane. Correct option is therefore A. Question 23. Iodoethane CH3CH2I reacts with aqueous silver nitrate at 50 degrees centigrade. A precipitate forms during this reaction. Which row of the table is correct about this reaction? We have iodoethane CH3CH2I. Iodine is more electronegative, so the charge is partial negative, while carbon will become partial positive. Now this is going to react with silver nitrate aqueous. It means we have silver nitrate present in the form of ions, and we also have water present. As the temperature is 50 degrees centigrade, so water will act as a nucleophile and OH will attach itself with the partial positive carbon atom. So by nucleophilic substitution, we would have the product CH3CH2OH, and I negative is removed. We also have silver nitrate present, so silver ion will react with iodide to form AgI. Let's move towards the option. The type of organic reaction was substitution, and OH was acting as a nucleophile, so this is nucleophilic substitution reaction. So it could be C or D. Second is the color of precipitate. As silver iodide is formed, which is yellow in color, so therefore the color of precipitate will be yellow. Correct option is therefore D. Question 23. 1-chloro-2-methylbutane reacts with sodium cyanide in ethanol in a nucleophilic substitution reaction. What is most likely intermediate or transition state in this reaction? We have 1-chloro-2-methylbutane, so we can draw the structure. Chlorine will be on first carbon. Methyl will be on second carbon. As it reacts with sodium cyanide, so we have nucleophile as cyanide. As chlorine is more electronegative than carbon, so therefore carbon will become partial positive and chlorine will become partial negative. And this will attack on this carbon atom and this bond will be broken. And Cl will take the electrons. Also, two hydrogen atoms are present with this carbon. One with this, three with this, two with this, and three with this carbon. The intermediate form will be like this. We have CH2. Chlorine bond is being broken. CN bond is being formed. We have CH, CH3, CH2, and CH3. Now we have one chlorine atom bonded to this carbon, two hydrogen atoms, one CN, and one is this alkyl group. Let's look at the transition states. In A, we have two hydrogen atoms, one CN, one chlorine, and a group of alkyl in which second carbon has CH3. In B, we have Cl, CN, and two CH3 attached, which are actually wrong. In C, we have carbocation being formed. In D, again, we have a carbocation being formed, which is incorrect. So the only correct option is A. Question 38. Bromoethane undergoes nucleophilic substitution reactions. Which statements are correct? Now, the general equation for nucleophilic substitution reaction for bromoethane could be written like this. We have two carbon atoms for bromoethane and Br is also attached. As bromine is partial negative and carbon is partial positive, so therefore nucleophile having lone pair of electron or negative charge will attack on this partial positive carbon and bromine will take electrons from this bond. So the product formed is like this. We have nucleophile being attached with carbon atom and bromine atom is removed in the form of negative ion. Let's look into the options. In option 1, bromoethane reacts with aqueous sodium hydroxide to make ethanol. So the reaction will be similar to as the one given. We have bromoethane and it will react with aqueous OH. What will happen that OH will be attached with carbon atom and bromine will be removed in the form of negative ion. As 2 carbon OH is ethanol, so therefore option 1 is correct. Option 2, bromoethane reacts with ethanolic NH3 to make ethylamine. Let's look into this reaction. We have 2 carbon atoms, 1 bromine. Partial negative for bromine, partial positive for carbon. We have ammonia, NH3. With nitrogen having lone pair of electrons, it will attack on partial positive carbon. This bond will be removed. Now the product formed is 2 carbon atoms with nitrogen and one of the hydrogen atom will be removed from nitrogen because nitrogen can make only 3 covalent bonds. So the hydrogen atom from ammonia and Br from bromoethane will form HBr molecule. Now the product formed is like this. We have CH3, 3 hydrogen atom with first carbon, then CH2, 2 hydrogen atoms with second carbon, then we have NH2. So whenever NH2 is present with alkyl group, the name is ethyl amine. So option 2 is also Correct. Option 3, bromoethane reacts with ethanolic KCN to make ethane nitrile. Let's write equation for this reaction. We have bromoethane. As KCN will produce K plus and CN negative, and there is a lone pair present on cyanide. So therefore it will attack partial positive carbon. The product formed will be like this. We have CN attached with carbon atom and Br will be removed in the form of negative ion. We can write this product as CH3 as there are 3 hydrogen atoms with this carbon, then CH2 as 2 hydrogen atoms are with this carbon, and then we have triple bond between carbon and nitrogen, so it will be CN. Now let's name this compound. We have 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms. And nitrogen is triple bonded with one of the carbon atoms, so it is propane nitrile. As propane nitrile is formed instead of ethane nitrile, so therefore this option is incorrect. So option 1 and 2 are correct, so therefore answer is B. Question 37. In which reactions is the major product formed by a nucleophilic substitution reaction? We have bromoethane and potassium cyanide, ammonia and hot concentrated sodium hydroxide in ethanol. Let's look into the first reaction. We have bromoethane. Ethane is the one having two carbon atoms and bromine is also present, plus potassium cyanide. Now KCN can provide cyanide nucleophile. This nucleophile will attack partial positive carbon and this Br is eliminated. So this is called nucleophilic substitution because CN negative is a nucleophile. The product formed will be CN plus KBr. As this product is formed by nucleophilic substitution, so therefore this one is correct. Again, in second we have bromoethane, two carbon atoms and bromine, plus ammonia. We have ethanolic ammonia. Now ammonia is also a nucleophile as it has a lone pair of electrons. It will provide its lone pair to partial positive carbon atom and this bond will be broken. So the product formed is, we have two carbon atoms, then we have NH2 and HBr is lost. Again, we can see that this is nucleophilic substitution as Br is substituted by NH2. So option 2 is also correct. In third one, we have bromoethane and hot concentrated sodium hydroxide and ethanol. This will cause elimination reaction. On one carbon, we have bromine. On second carbon, hydrogen will be eliminated. The product formed will be alkene. And it will form NaBr and H2O. So this is not a nucleophilic substitution reaction, this is elimination reaction. So third is incorrect. As first two options are correct, answer is B. Question 38, a reaction mechanism is shown. This is the reaction. Which statement about this reaction are correct? Number 1, it is a substitution reaction. Now we can see in the reaction that OH replaces Cl and Cl has been kicked out. So therefore option 1 is correct. Option 2, OH negative behaves as a nucleophile as OH negative has a lone pair of electron and it is attacking to the partial positive carbon atom. So therefore it is behaving as a nucleophile. This is correct. Third is heterolytic bond fission is involved. As we can see between carbon and chlorine, chlorine becomes negative. and carbon is positive. So chlorine atom takes both electrons involved in the bond between carbon and chlorine. So therefore chlorine becomes negative, so it is heterolytic bond fission. All three options are correct, therefore it is A. Question 21. An organic ion containing a carbon atom with a negative charge is called carbanion. An organic ion containing a carbon atom with a positive charge is called carbocation. The reaction between aqueous sodium hydroxide and 1-bromobutane proceeds by an SN2 mechanism. What is the first step in the mechanism? Now, 1-bromobutane is primary halogenoalkane. As bromine is attached with this carbon and it is directly attached to just one carbon atom, so it is primary halogenoalkane. Now bromine is more electronegative, so it has partial negative charge and carbon would have partial positive charge. Now as we have sodium hydroxide, so what happens that hydroxide attacks this partial positive carbon and this bond is broken. Now intermediate is formed in which carbon-bromine bond is being broken and new carbon-OH bond is being formed. Let's move towards the options. A. Attack by a nucleophile on carbon atom with a partial positive charge. As OH is a nucleophile and it attacks partial positive carbon, so this is correct. B. Heterolytic bond fission followed by attack by an electrophile on carbanion. Now heterolytic bond fission does not take place in primary halogenoalkane, it takes place in tertiary halogenoalkanes. Again in C we have heterolytic bond fission. It will take place only in tertiary halogenoalkanes, not in primary. D. Homolytic bond fission. This is incorrect because no radicals are being produced and no bond is being broken by itself. The only correct option is therefore A. Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.